So there are two other things that you have to look at is whether your thermostat, which is located right there, and this thermostat is connected to the primary computer of the engine, and also to the relay. So this one detects at what temperature it needs to turn the fan on. And also there is another temperature sensor, which it's over in the back of that engine over there. And that's one which shows what the engine temperature is at the gauges. So if you want to replace this, you will need a deep socket. I have I think this is a 3/4 deep socket. Yes, it's a 3/4 deep socket, because you don't want to damage the harness in the back. So what you have to do is you take this, the clip off. Again, if you press on this, and it will come off, it will slide off. And you can see the two leads which go into the socket. And then this one will fit over this plastic part. You don't want to damage this plastic part when you are putting it in or pulling it out. And this socket goes in it. You need a 3x4 deep socket. And this is what I used. And once you unscrew the old one, and then you can screw it, there will be a little radiator fluid coming out, or the cooling fluid that will be coming out, but that's okay. And do it when your engine is cold. You don't want to open it when your engine is hot. So I'm going to put it back here, and this locks right in. There is also the thermostat. If you have coolant issues, you also may need to look at the thermostat. In my case, the engine temperature was going down as soon as I went on the highway. So whenever there was air flowing through the radiator, it was cooling it down. So I figured that it's not the problem with the thermostat, but you may be able to replace the thermostat while your cooling fan is off, because it gives you more access to it. I'm not going to replace the thermostat at this point, but that's something else you may want to look at.